Good evening. I was instructed to stand somewhere around here.
You can stand.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm going to talk about Flash. I'm going to try not to turn this into a marketing event for Flash. I've been asked to talk about more of sort of the leadership challenges associated with trying to establish this business in Sierra Leone. I called my presentation Money with Wings, and somewhere down the line, I will make that connection to the title. All right. Let's go. So that's the agenda. Okay. Now, when we talk about mobile money, a lot of times people think about it just as a product for the poor and for the unbanked. For us, that's a very important part of what we want to do. The statistics say that we have approximately 2 million phone subscribers in Sierra Leone and only 300,000 bank account holders. So there's a huge gap of people with no bank accounts, but who have phones. And we want all of those people. But we also want the elite, the people with bank accounts, all of those people, we believe there's a product for them as well. Now, I have a prepaid utility account, power account. And my power goes out, and when I think of the pain of going through that process of going to buy top up for my meter, going home, putting in my code, if you were flying from Freetown to Accra, you would get to Accra before I get electricity. So we are here to fix some of those problems. So let's go on with this. If you think about how this thing works, we operate with a network of agents around the country. So if I wanted to send money from Freetown to Sierra Leone, for example, first thing I would do is go to an agent, give them physical cash. In exchange, I get electronic money in my phone. With a simple text message, I send that money to somebody in Bo. That person goes to an agent. With a simple text message in Bo, the customer sends that electronic money to the agent B. In exchange, the agent gives the customer physical cash, less whatever fees are incurred. Now, this process is not just for money transfer. It's for payments, and it's not just for individuals, it's for corporates. In Sierra Leone, in 2012, we still have businesses that put cash in cars, drive them 2 to 3 hours to pay salaries and stuff like that. There are probably some NGOs represented here who do that. Okay. We are here to solve that problem. You have an online account, you go in, you load a spreadsheet, name, phone number, amount, you hit a button, 300 people get their money in their phones, they can just go collect the cash at any Splash agent location. So here are some of the things that we're doing today. There's a microfinance company called Hope Micro. This is how they disburse loans to borrowers. So once loans are approved, there's no need for anybody to go to Hope to collect cash or to pick up a check. Money comes into your phone, and we have 100% electronic tracking. You can go and collect the cash. I have DSTV in my house. Every month, I sit in my house while I'm watching Manchester United playing. I can pay my bill in a certain time. There's a juice processing factory called Africa Felix Juice. They have farmers all over the country who they source fruit from to process. A lot of them who are unbanked are being paid through Splash. And airtime top up. The money from my phone right now, I can buy top up for my own phone or for any of your phones sitting here today. I don't need to go out on the streets to look for a credit side. So these are some of the things that we're doing here, which when you add it all up, I think there's so much developmental impact because of productivity gains, but also because we're bringing more transparency and financial inclusion. So now I'll go and talk a little bit about the challenge of trying to establish this business. Have a quick pop quiz first. Okay. With this paper that I have here, I'm famous for this quiz, so some of you may have heard it before. If I folded this 50 times, I want you guys to look at the answers and think about how high you think this paper would be if I could physically fold this 50 times. So I've just done one fold, two, three, four. And I want all of you to think about how high you think that paper would be. Here are the options from A to B. Okay? All of you, think of your answers. I'll give you 3 more seconds before I jump to the next. Okay, let's go. So if you said the answer was E, which is higher than the distance from Freetown to Kono, congrats. Okay. The actual answer is that it would be higher than the distance from here to the sun. Yeah. And it's a mathematical equation that I'll be happy to explain to you in private. Now, here's the idea. Every time you double this, your thickness doubles. It's an exponential equation. Okay. But what happens is that up until about the 42nd fold, you don't really feel like you're seeing anything happening. Okay. It's not until you get to that tipping point where every time you double, you're now making some serious incremental gains. And the next thing you know, you're higher than the distance from here to the sun. What's the relevance? Let's go. That's where Splash is today. Let's go. That's where Splash wants to be. Okay? And my challenge is to make this happen. Okay? That's it. And so what I want to talk about is the things that keep me up at night while I try to get us to that point. Okay. I think of my job as trying to put all of the different pieces together to drive us to this tipping point. Okay. And here are all the things that I have to worry about. I have external challenges and internal challenges. My first external challenge is I need to drive behavioral change. I need people in Sierra Leone to understand that having money in your phone is like holding physical cash. Okay, that's a huge leap for a lot of people. And that's, when I talk about money with wings, that's what we're trying to do. We need to go to people all over Sierra Leone, from Freetown to Konedugu, and tell them that splash cash in your phone is like money. The only difference is it has wings. So you don't need to travel around to collect cash, let the money fly for you. Yeah, and that's one, and that's sort of how we think of what we're trying to do. I have to build public trust in this. So I need people to understand that nobody's going to steal their money. We certainly are not going to steal that money. We need institutions. Everybody needs to understand. I think I'm moving my hands faster than you. I need to gain institutional support. So we need government to want this to be successful in Sierra Leone. We need our banks and our telecom operators to want this to work. We need NGOs, development organizations to want this to work. You need a whole ecosystem of champions to make this go to that tipping point. On the internal side, I have investors who are pumping lots of money in this thing and want to begin to see some returns. They've been doing it for 3 years now, still waiting for a return. And I have to manage a team, which right now is about 70 people, full-time and freelancers. A lot of them require serious direction, but also serious motivation by way of incentives and disincentive. Okay, so all of this may happen when you get a truck that's moving towards the tipping point. Okay? Let's go. On driving behavioral change, for us, that's marketing and customer education. We're constantly pushing ourselves to try new ways of explaining this stuff to people. You might think that it's difficult only for the illiterate population, but honestly, even some of the most sophisticated people, you'll be surprised how hard it is to explain this stuff and to get them to buy in. So we spend a lot of money, but we also have to be very creative about doing this stuff. Building public trust, the best way to do it is you need to deliver. When you tell somebody that you make a transfer from here to go, the person on the other end will receive the money. We need to make sure that that's happening. So that's our agent network, making sure they're sufficiently liquidated every time to do cash out. It's our security, making sure that people are not accusing us basically of losing money because they use it too much. And it's about customer service. So, these are things that I am constantly looking for ways to improve. Then on institutional support, I think there's a lot of politicking, there's a lot of relationship building, but the most important thing is to always try to understand what are the incentives of all of the different people. Okay. What is it that I have to tell somebody at the World Bank about Splash to make the World Bank want to promote this work? What do I have to tell somebody at Ministry of Social Welfare to make them want Splash to succeed? And that is big challenge, because you're dealing with different people, different motivations, different incentives, these things you can learn it in school, but it's not until you're on the ground that you really understand the challenge. And then, you know, on investors, I mean, for us, the big challenge there is they need to continue to believe that we're doing all of the right things to get this to a point where they actually get a return. And that's about constant communication, being honest about things we do that don't work, and also being able to defend the things that we decide to do, even when they don't work. Then on the team, you know, I was lucky because when I was in school, I got to listen to a lot of great CEOs and great managers. And one thing that always struck me, a lot of them would always say, it's about letting everybody understand your vision. And I remember listening to the CEO of Nissan, who said, you know, his challenge to himself was that if at any time he stopped anybody in his office, in the hallways, even if it was the janitor needed to be able to tell him his vision. And that is something that Inside Splash I've really taken on board, and I always want to make sure that people understand why we're doing the things that we're doing. And to the point where, you know, I remember one time I held a meeting and I said, every one of you must be a salesman. And the next day, even the driver came with a list of 20 people that he wanted us to sign up for Splash. And that's the kind of thing that you need to do to keep this going. It's about empowering the team. So I always tell them, you know, don't be intimidated. Come and tell me anything you want, any ideas you have. If it makes sense, we'll implement. If it doesn't make sense, just keep coming with new ideas. People need to feel like they're not being judged on those ideas. Just keep on brainstorming. And leading by example. So again, I want people to understand that when I send them out in the rain to go do a street show, to stop people and talk to them, that it's because I myself will do it too. And that's something that, you know, since I came into Splash, I think I've seen that make a difference, because, you know, there'll be times where we've been like hounding people in the stadium during like different festivals and stuff at midnight, and I'm there with them and people are surprised that, you know, I was like, I can't send you out to do it when I'm not doing it. And then obviously you want to reward people. So one of the things that I did when I came in, I completely changed the way we pay people. And I guess, you know, because I worked on Wall Street before coming in, I did, you know, all this thing about bonuses. We now have a structure at Splash where some people can get up to double their salary through bonuses depending on performance. And we have seen how that has driven you know, the commitment to the things that we're trying to do. You know, you can't give the cards without mistakes. So I also punish bad behavior. So if you're late, you know that I could be taking that from your salary. If you show up, you don't show up with no excuse, I'm going to hit it on your side, it's going to hit your side. So there are things like that that I feel like have seemed to make a difference. And then the last thing is obviously you want to celebrate the wins. So every new contract we get, we jump up and down, but we still have to remember that we're still at the very early stages of this journey. And so we do celebrate, but we still have to stay hungry. Let's go on, please. Okay, so just a brief sort of description of where we think we're going to go with Splash. Okay. Today we're just in Sierra Leone, and all we do is mobile money. Okay. 5 years from now, you know, where we really want to be is a regional bank. Okay. With no branches, just doing deposits, credit, everything through mobile channels. Now, that is a pretty tough journey. In between, well, first thing we need to do is just replicate the simple model that we've in a number of other countries. And we've started looking at Liberia, Gambia, Ghana, also thinking of some Francophone markets. So the idea is to first establish this system where we're just doing the mobile money stuff, and then at some point we can go get a banking license of some sort to slap on it, and then begin to offer our own product, which will hopefully dramatically improve financial inclusion, especially at the bottom of the pyramid. Now, it's hard enough trying to do this in one country. And so when you talk about doing this in multiple countries, obviously, there's a whole new dimension in terms of the challenges that you face, as well as now having to really begin to think more about sort of the cross-cultural issues. Now, luckily, you know, I'm from Ghana, but I'm working in Sierra Leone. I actually don't think the cultures are dramatically different, so it's been not too difficult. But I don't know what it's going to be like when I start looking at things in Guinea or Cote d'Ivoire. I might have to actually beef up my French a little bit first, but I anticipate that there'll be a whole number of challenges, not just for the business, but also for myself. And the key is to continue to learn from the mistakes that are being made here and surround myself with good advisors who have done these things, and tons of people that have had, and to learn from those. So, on that note, I think I'm just going to wrap up with the final statement, which is that we truly believe that mobile money is the future of financial services in Africa. And to the extent that there are people in here that could be supportive stakeholders and champions of this movement, please don't hesitate to reach out to Splash, and we'll be delighted to work with you. On that note, I think I'm done.